YouTube. Welcome again. This is episode 31. And I have a few things to show you guys here. And then a few things to do later. So, it seems to be working. But sometimes it still does freeze. Or a lighthouse. Here's our village. So, our chicken farm is fully functional now. I had to put a ladder here so that I could fill up the dispenser easily. And the chicken farm seems to be working properly with no escaping chickens. And we get the eggs down here. And that is not a house, mister. Get out of there right now. That is not a house. Just because it has a door doesn't mean it's a house. It's a house for the chickens. Get out of here. Okay, excuse me. Please leave. Please. Thank you. Please. Come on, man. Get out of here. This is not a house. Not for you. Thank you. Okay. A major change here. I built a blacksmith's house. I just stuck it here beside the portal, and I actually had to move the portal over one block, so I had to take down all those blocks, and I had to take down all these blocks, and then shift it over, but it's fine now. So this is an exact replica of the standard blacksmith's house, except without the stuff on the inside. So it's got two furnaces, the lava. You can't really see out of these windows here because of the portal. And we got a chest with diamonds in it. I just stuck this in here for fun. I'm not having the tables there or anything. So I think that looks pretty good here. On the steps over here. Filled up this empty spot. Here's the portal. So, yeah. It's kind of big, but fills up that place nicely. Another thing is, I moved the Reed's farm over to this side. Hello, mister. I moved it inside the village, so instead of 7 rows, we only have 3. But that's still good enough, because any more than that would make it way too big. So, we still get about a stack of reeds from here. Another thing, the grass finally grew. That one block I placed here last episode has spread, and I think it, even though it's not bright green grass, I think it looks way better than just brown dirt. So, that's done for both of these, one over there, and the second one over here. Let's see. There we go. Very nice, very nice. What else? I feel like I'm forgetting something. Cows are still the same. Need to breed a bit more. All the houses I added to the village seem to be working. I think that there's a few more villagers now, even though I can't keep track of them since they keep moving so much. So, okay, the tree farm is still the same. So I think that's about it. I feel like I'm forgetting something, but I guess I'm not. Got eggs coming here, so those open the door when they fall on that pressure plate, so yeah. Okay, so put eggs in there. Quickly just fire them. Okay. So this episode, I'm not sure what I'm going to be doing. I have a small list of stuff to do, but eventually this place over here, that small spot, needs to be filled up, and so does this spot over here. which are, I think, the last two places that are empty. One thing is 5,000 views on my channel, which is awesome. Thank you guys for all that. I'm probably gonna make like a celebration once we get to 10,000. I've also been recording some different types of videos lately because I've been having some spare time and wanted to do something different. A few are tours of my old worlds, so I think there's gonna be two. One is the first world I ever made, single player, boring, has not much in it, and the second one will be of the second world I made, which is a server. The server I always played on before I made this LP, so that one will obviously be better than the first. And also some music that I made a long time ago, but never got around to uploading it. So you'll be seeing that soon. Okay, let me check my list of stuff here to do, because I have a couple things to do. Build houses for the villagers, I've already done that. Yes. Two very important things I have to do. Number one, actually it's three. Number one is return the prank that Scapegoat and the Melon God did to my village. They placed blocks around. So there's a few that I'm probably not gonna do though, since they're kind of like boring. Just the standard one of placing random blocks everywhere, and then there's the one placing water. Placing chickens everywhere. One thing I think that would be kind of funny would be placing snow golems there. Which, yes, it's kind of a boring prank. It's been done before, but I think it would be really funny having snow golems walking around on jungle trees. So I'll probably have to do that next episode, because I think that will take up a whole lot of time to do that. And another thing we had to do as well was potions. That small potion room I have over there to make potions is not big enough to store potions, so it stores the materials for potions, but we're gonna need to make another room for all of that. We could put it in that empty house that we have over there, the butcher's house, which is empty right now, but I'm not sure what I want to put there. I'm sort of leaving it empty, or I'm not sure why, I've got no idea, but I'll probably stick something in there another time, which will not be potions. I want the potions all in one place. Or maybe it should be potions, I'm not sure. Now that's really unclear to me, whether it should be underground of the house with the potions, or it should be here. I think to make it easier, we'll just put it in here. Just so that it's a bit neater than usual. Okay, we can either fit 1, 2, 3, 4 double chests, or we can fit 1, 2, 3, 4. I sort of don't want them on the ceiling, because it's kind of in the way, and I think I'll put them horizontal. So, 2 over there, and 2 in front. So these will all be potions. So half of these will be bad potions, half of them will be good potions. So there is actually, poison and potion of harming and instant damage, that stuff will be bad, and then the healing, regenerate, other stuff will be the good potions. So, yeah, that's what we're going to do. I guess we don't have to do anything now. I was thinking that we would have to dig underground, but I guess if we put it here, it's just as good. And it's easier. So I'm not gonna make you guys watch me do potions, I guess. That potions room is complete, I guess. Maybe another time I might change this to iron blocks to keep with the same potions look as the brewing house. But it wouldn't really look good with the jack-o'-lanterns. Jack-o'-lanterns go better with nether bricks. And nether bricks is the style I have for the enchantment room, so I probably won't be doing anything with that. Okay, so potion brewing, potion storage is done. Okay, I guess we can actually return the prank, because I don't have anything else on my list right now of easy stuff to do. There's some difficult stuff that still hasn't occurred, like go search for a second stronghold, or go to the end, or go find another nether fortress, which I've tried and have failed various times, so I really don't want to waste my time in the nether anymore, because it's kind of boring. So I think we're going to make half a stack, or stack of snow golems. I'm not sure how much I'm going to want to make. Let's just take a stack of snow golems for now and see how much we use, because I'm going to use quite a bit of pumpkins on that too. So I think no one's on right now. Yup. Let's hop over to scapegoat and the melon god's house. And oh, I should take a sign actually. I'll probably put something like, well, what they did to me was, they said, "Yo, dog, heard you like signs." Well, I'll probably put something like, "Yo, dog, I heard you like snow," or something better than that, probably. That one's kind of lame. "Heard you like company." That would be good. Snow golems are kind of friendly, but it will be a pain in the ass to clean up all that snow everywhere. So that's kind of the point. Well, actually, no, I don't think they leave snow. I don't think snow golems leave snow unless they are, in a snow biome. So that's actually not going to work for us, but they'll be around, walking around in their way. I'll probably fill their houses with them, so it will still be effective in a way. Okay, I just got to get there. I'll place the signs first. I hope they don't go on now. This is usually the time that they go on. So, yeah. The melon god has a very big treehouse. So, uh-oh. So, there's his treehouse right beside scapegoat's house. What was that minecart doing here? I think someone's stealing my minecarts on my minecart tracks, since I've been losing them a lot and they just disappear. And whoa, look, that's ridiculous. Actually, this would look better if it was a mushroom. Oh, actually, I should grow some giant mushrooms. I haven't grown any on this server at all. So let's put a sign here. Oh, damn. Maybe I should ban them for a couple of minutes. No, just kidding. I wouldn't do that. Okay, yes, I can do it to scapegoat first, since he's not on right now, and hope tactical crowd doesn't see this. Okay, I think scapegoat added a treehouse to his building here. Let's go check it out. Maybe it's not scapegoats. I think it's scapegoats. Yeah, or it could be one of his friends, but it's probably scapegoat's house. So let's check this out. Oh yes, tactical crab left the game. T for Thomas, which is his name. This is actually pretty nice. I like the design and stuff. Staircase going up. Nice checkered. And we have a third floor, or no, just a porch. Oh, he joined again. Never mind. Guess he's probably gonna be on for a while, but that's a neat house scapegoat has made himself. I like it. I'll put snow globes in here as well. How great is that? But the sign will be in his original house, since I think that's where he has all his storage and all his main stuff. This is more of a kind of a hotel-like place. Jungle trees on a mountain biome. How odd is that? Oh, I hate these stairs. You can have to go back down if you fall off. Okay, so let's put it here, right in the center. Put a face on that. Okay, let's get started. Let's start in rows. I think that snow golems only die when they're in a desert, so it should work here. Okay. Let's hope for the best. Yes. Oh, does it actually make snow? That's really cool. That's awesome. So this is going to be full of snow. We're going to put them all over the mountain as well. And all over his other house. This is ridiculous. Oh, I love snow golems. So much fun. Okay, let's put actually half a stack in his house. And, oops. Oh, it actually goes through the painting. That's weird. Okay. There we go. I think that's pretty cool. Well, actually, that's not half a stack. That's only 16 snow golems. But it's good enough. And let's try to get out of here before they escape, and whoa, there's snow there already. I guess he glitched through the wall. Let's see what it looks like from here. Tactical Crab is still having fun, I guess. Oh, Scapegoat? He joined? Oh my god. But I think he's in a cave. He was mining earlier, so I'm hoping that he didn't get back yet, because that would be kind of disastrous since I already placed all the snow golems in his house. Let's do the one over here, too. Actually, let's put put this here, too. Come on, guys. Wander around. Make my prank a good prank. So I guess I can do Tactical Crab another time, because he's on right now, and we don't want him to suspect. He'll probably think that I'm only pranking Scapegoat, because I think Scapegoat did it, and then he'll be like, what, me too? Once he sees all these snow golems all over his treehouse. So... Hello again. Right now, I am all ready to build my house, but we have some time, and it's early in the morning here, so... Oops. So, the tactical crab is not on right now, and we're gonna go do the same prank on him. I couldn't think of anything else that was non-TNT and non-fire for him. So we're just gonna do the same thing that we did to Scapegoat. And I'll make sure that I'm recording this the whole way, so... Oh, whoops. Hello, chicken. So, as you can see, Scapegoat's already cleaned this up. And he took the prank wall, so that's good. It's all nice and everything. And now the tactical crab is unsuspecting of any of this. So this is his treehouse, in case you haven't seen it before. With different platforms and all kinds of stuff, but we're gonna put the signs here first. Oops, okay, I didn't think. I forgot about... Hey, I hope you didn't think I forgot about you. Are you or lonely? Okay, so, hey, I hope you didn't think I forgot about you. I heard you were lonely as well, you tree dweller. Well, you can thank Scapegoat. Whoops, you can thank... Happy face. Hey, I hope you didn't think I forgot about you. I heard you were lonely as well, you tree dweller. You can thank Scapegoat for telling me that you did it too. Enjoy. Perfect, okay, let's get started. I'm not sure if we have much time. Probably, since he usually doesn't go on this early in the morning, so... I'm not rushing as much as I was last time. Oh no, why? Don't tell me they die here. Oh shoot. Aw, that's gonna fail. Okay, well that's a problem if they can't live in jungle biomes. That means that we're gonna need to find something else to do since... Oh, this one's fine. Maybe there was something over there? I don't know. Well, that was a waste of snow anyways, so... What's wrong with these? Can they not go on wood? Maybe only on leaves? I haven't researched this, so... Oh yeah, they can only go on leaves. Oh shoot. Man, what are we gonna do? Uh-oh. Okay, we gotta find a different prank and quick. Because I already put the signs there, I'm not taking them down. Okay, well, I'm actually not gonna go back. Let's just leave snow blocks everywhere, since I guess snow golems aren't gonna work for us. Snow blocks are always another possibility, since they also leave snow. So, let's start putting them everywhere. Big tree house. This is a really big tree house. Okay, well, I gotta put another sign, I guess. Scapegoat might have some wood, because I don't have any. No! Fail. Okay, whatever. Let's see, I think I need one sign. Whoops. Don't work in this stupid biome. I think we're gonna just put all these around, and that's what we're gonna do. It's not as well, how I expected it, or how I wanted it to be, but I guess that's the best we can do in this situation. Whoops. And I think another thing that would be cool is if we could put them under so that it would be way more difficult for him to get at. If you put it like under the branches and stuff, then he'd have to like go from the bottom. Okay, how to get up there? I missed an exit. There's... Yes, here it is. Okay. Take that, spider. there on the edges like that. Basically everywhere I can think of. Nearby trees would work nicely too. Oh, you can place them on vines. That's sweet. Awesome. Hello, little chicken. Let's see how to get up. Here we go. Snow there. Snow there. Snow there. Snow here as well. Continue going up. This is a more difficult one than the prank I did on scapegoat, since this is actually blocks that I'm placing, not a mob. And he's gonna have to remove all of these before he can actually move around freely. And here we go. We'll actually place golems here, since I think they're too high up to... Aww. That's sad. I'm gonna have to check the wiki, see what's the problem with this. Since it's usually not supposed to. I'm not sure why they dine, if they're above world height, if they're on leaves, if it's too sunny outside, I got no idea. So I'm gonna have to figure that out another time. Until I get this right, but we have no time for that now, so. Okay, time for pumpkins. Oh, I guess you can't place them on leaves. It's a small golem. Okay, I guess we'll place them on wood then. If there's no leaves, there's wood. There. I thought you could place them on fences. That's weird. Oh, I blocked this off. Never mind. Let's go this way. Okay, what else? What else? Here. 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 Trying to look for all the empty spaces. I probably should have brought more snow, but I didn't expect this to happen. Well, snow blocks and melons still work. Well, not melons. Pumpkins. It's good enough. Few last ones, 23. Quickly just place them around. Oh, this is gonna be a pain to clean up. Look at that. It looks like the snow golems have like fallen apart or something. Ah, oh, that's so cool. I bet he likes it too. It's like an explosion of snow and other stuff. Haha. What you gonna do about that now? Okay, let's put some on the bridge as well. I think this is his bridge, so. That looks beautiful. Yes. Okay, I think that's good enough for the prank right now. So let's get back to the village. And, okay. So we'll start building my house now. Or we can call it the sky base. Hello, chicken. Let's get out of here. Yeah. Probably not gonna use TNT for any kind of pranks because that's damaging, and neither fire, because fire would seriously burn down all his trees that he's built over there, and that took him quite a long time. So yeah, nothing that will wreck anything. So only additives, adding blocks, adding mobs, whatever it is, but no destroying, because then that's not nice. So yeah. Okay, so we're gonna have to go back to the sky level. Before I talked quite a lot about this when I thought I was recording, but in the end I wasn't. So I'm not gonna repeat myself, it's just boring stuff, and I'm just gonna go ahead and start building this. And try not to die, obviously, since it's kind of high up. Okay. The village is that way, right? Please load. Come on. Load. I'm just staring into empty space. Well, the pathways are white, so it's still not loading. It's so slow. Okay, so I think it's this way. Let's put an exit like here. So one, two, three, four, let's have it at least 8 away. Then this would be the first circle here with a pass through. Actually, let's make this 16. I might in the end change what blocks I'm using because I'm not totally convinced that I like wool. I usually don't build with wool, so I'm not really used to it, the texture. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. And right now we're right over there, so it will be mostly centered over the village. Diameter of maybe 8 or 10, and then the large one in the center will be 12. Five, six, seven, eight. I think 8 is a good enough size. I don't want it to be too large, because then you won't really notice a difference between the small ones and the large center one. So this is the main size. 2, 3. And now we just gotta figure out how to make this circular, so. That doesn't look very circular to me. I think that's better. That's circular enough. Whoops. It's getting dark up here too. I'm not sure if mobs can spawn on... Well, I think they can. So, this the center? Yes, it is. Perfect. I think I'm gonna like how this turns out. So, here's our first circle with a white path going to it. I'm not sure if I'm gonna keep these materials, but I wanna make the template first out of something easy. So, this might be too small actually. I'd have to test it out. Let's go down and look. Take a look at it from down here, see what it looks like. I guess from here you can't really notice the colors that much, so. Well, you can't notice the texture of the colors, so it's not really gonna matter. But when I'm inside the house, I'm gonna want it to be nice. So, that's a good size. I don't want it too large, but the path that goes to it from the tower, I'm gonna want to change that and use glass, because I want it to be sort of suspended in midair, and having that white path going there isn't gonna really work for us. So I'm just gonna get the base done so that you don't have to watch me do the same thing over and over, and then I'll show you guys what I get done. I might change a few things, because I'm not sure what materials I want to be using yet. So, yeah, I'll just go do that now. And see you guys in a short while. Hello again, and this is it. I've made the paths glass, actually, so you can see through. And these are the platforms. I ran out of black wool, though. So I'm gonna have to get more, and Scapegoat's on right now, and he just told me that I pranked the wrong person, because that treehouse was actually not the tactical crabs, that was the melon gods, and he didn't prank me, so... Oops, I'm sorry, melon god, but... Yeah, so... Obviously... We failed at that. It was a good prank, though. It's a big mess over there right now. So what we're gonna do is go over to the tactical crab's house and actually prank him. So I think that snow golems might work where his house is. You saw it a short while ago, and we'll continue this next episode. So, we're gonna finish the episode by pranking Tactical Crab, and we're gonna go do that right now. Okay. So, yep, I think this is gonna be the end of this episode. I hope you liked it. So, yeah, I'll continue that stuff next time. I think it looks pretty good, though. 5 circles up in the sky, and I'm going the wrong way, And, oh, I might as well take a minecart instead of run all the way there. That's what we got minecart rails for. Here we go. So, yeah, that was sort of... Oh, man. I suck at those jumps. Anyways, as I was saying, we're gonna go prank him. Same prank as always. I wanna stick with my snow golem. And is my stuff still here? Yes, it is. And it's invisible. How awesome is that? Come on, I can't see anything. Just show it to me. This is ridiculous. Come on. Get back on there. Where's all my stuff? That's not all my stuff. I'm missing something. What am I missing, though? Let's see. I got my unbreaking pickaxe. I got a fortune pickaxe. Got food. Got axe. Got shovel. Got shovel. Got axe. Got bow. Got sword. Torches. Sticks, and oh, I'm missing arrows. Where are my arrows? Oh, there's my glass. There's my arrows. Am I missing something? Hope I'm not. It's a big explosion radius of all my stuff. And have all the stuff necessary. I might be missing something, but that doesn't matter. Because we're gonna go prank somebody. Oh, and I forgot to take signs. I'll take some from, wait. Scapegoat's cleaning up the Melon God's house. Now I feel sorry for him. Because it wasn't his fault. And neither was the Melon Gods. But, oh well. We'll learn from that. Let's see, we're skipping. I think he's busy doing all that. Whoops. Did I fail at that? Yes, I did. Awesome, let's go. Let's go do this. I'm stuck. Sign still here. So I apologize. That was a fail. Oh shoot. Oops. I'm not fixing that. Let's get out of here. That was, man, I feel so bad for Scapegoat now that he's doing all this for the Melon God who did nothing. Okay, I think his house is over here. Stairs. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Yeah, there it is. Okay, let's see if the snow golems work here, because they obviously didn't work in the jungle biome. And this is just a regular forest biome, so... The house of the... Okay, let's reverse this sign. So, house of the tactical crab. Whoops. crab. Whoops. Tactical crab. A tactical crab. Perfect, okay. Okay, let's put the signs here. Okay, so. Hey. Hey, I hope you didn't think I forgot about you. Now you have enjoy. Perfect. He knows who I am, so I don't need to put my name or anything. So let's see if we can put a few snow golems outside here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, they work. Hello, guys. Okay, excuse me. Excuse me, excuse me. Friends in here. Oh. Oh god. That's not gonna work. Excuse me. You're in my way. Put a whole bunch in his house. Okay, now, I know this is taking a bit of a long time, but it's worth it, so you can continue watching if you want, and if you don't, you can just stop, because this is all we're going to be doing for the rest of this episode, making this house a mess, so. Come on. Okay, so I'm just going to finish this here and show you guys what it looks like when we have snow golems everywhere. Hello again. I've used almost all of my stuff, but that's not all. So we got tons and tons of snow golems just everywhere, and I love it. It's so nice. And ooh, looks like they're dying in the rain. Oh, okay. No, don't die. Okay, block this off, block this off. I guess they can't live in there. That's not good. Oh, shoot. Okay, I failed at that. Whatever. At least the ones in here are gonna... Are they dying here too? Oh yes, they die in water. Okay. Oh well, at least there's enough in here to make it obvious that it's a prank. So, yeah, I think this is good. And thank you guys for watching this. I'll tell you guys what he thinks of it next episode. So, yeah, I guess that's all that we've got. And thanks for watching. So, yeah. Whoa, look at all that snow. Let's see, how can we get out of this house now? Out of my way, out of my way, out of my way. Get out, get out, get out. I'm sorry, but I can't let you out. Okay, let's go fetch all those snowballs. It's glitching. See how it looks through the window. I guess you can't see much from there. So yeah, discovered a few new things this episode. Now snow golems die in water. And they also die in rain. And yeah, so thanks for watching, and I'll let you guys know how it goes.